Hello, everyone. We are waiting for Yanni to get up on here, okay? What's goody? Listen, we late, okay? We late. Let me just say I had some family problems I had to deal with just now, so that's why we late. I didn't mean to come. This is not even Haitian time. Haitian time would have been like at least 30 minutes to an hour from now. 30 minutes would have been early for Haitian time, but we are here. Let's just make sure everybody, well, listen, oh, wait, I'm wallin'. Hi, Yanni. I see her. Hold up. There you go.
Hi. I'm so excited.
Oh my God. See, I knew it. I was like, she better come on here natural because if this bitch got a full beat,
I'm mad because
I ain't had time to put the beat on.
I know who I'm dealing with.
What that mean?
I don't have to be all superficial.
You really don't.
You already know. Wine. I thought about coming on here and flat iron my wig. See?
Girl, so let's do the introductions. What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, as you can see. Yeah, okay. So today, we are going to be talking about high-value men. We have Yanni here. Introduce yourself.
Oh, I have to do an introduction? Hi, I'm Yanni, and I have a YouTube channel called Real Talk with Yanni. And, yeah, we keep it very blunt, but educational, healing, and just helpful.
Very true. If you guys do not watch Yanni, you genuinely have to because, listen, love her. At first when I watched her, I was like, too pretty for me. I was like, I don't know. You know how sometimes you'd be like, some pretty girls, especially on YouTube, they don't be of substance. I'm not even gonna lie. It's true shit. I call them, you know what I call them? Like, basic bitch tube. Like, they just put on makeup all day. They talk about they whack-ass diets. And, like, I'm telling you this right now. Like, I was like, I didn't think it was gonna be like of substance, but like y'all need to watch her from her weight loss journey to her dating advice to dragging people, even though she calls it not dragging y'all. We don't sip tea over
here. Let me tell you what happened to me today.
What happened?
Kit and Samuel strike both of my videos. I'm impressed. I didn't think he had the balls.
He striked you?
Yes.
What kind of strike? Copyright strike?
Yes.
It's fair use.
That's what I thought too.
That's abusing the system. So most likely all you have to do is refute it. Like he can't do nothing about that.
I don't feel like doing all that.
No, because if you get a copyright strike and if someone else wants to be an asshole, and you get three, your channel's gone in 2.5.
So I need to fight it.
Mm-hmm. Respond and say it's fair use, it's a reaction video, and it's commentary. He can't do nothing about that. Yeah. That goes for everything. People have tried me with community guideline strikes, and it's like, what do you talk about? I can talk about you if I want to. It's a free country. It's America, okay?
I mean, I thought that's what it was, but I'm, like, confused. But I knew it was coming.
You can literally talk about anybody, and realistically, they can't do nothing about it because of fair use. It's even if you use their videos. Like, typically, I don't like to deal with that. So, like, if I do talk about someone, most of the time, since, one, I'm lazy and I don't feel like adding the clips, another reason is because, like, that, because people could just be petty. But most of the time, you will win. You will most definitely win. Even if it's just a regular strike where they're like, oh, we'll claim the video and we make money from it, you will win.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's wild. I'm mad they did that. Like,
that's a little party. I'm like, what? Are you kidding me right now?
I mean, I'm sure he came for you because of what... I mean, I don't even... honestly, I actually started looking into some of his stuff. It's not bad. I really think that he has a lot of decent advice. He's just...
ruthless.
Yeah, and that's weird. I'm like, I can't really be mad at that because I'm like that. But I wouldn't do it to my own guy. I don't know. Like, he's not that.
You can be honest and not be bashful. You're right. I do it all the time. I'm honest, but I'm not going to be like, oh, you can't do better. I'm going to just be like, that ain't it. You could probably do better than what you're doing.
You're right. So... with that being said, y'all, let's get into today's topic because we're going to revisit that because I want to know. So anyhow, today's topic is genuinely, as you guys can tell, high value men. Okay, so everyone has their own definition of a high value man, but I believe it is very subjective. But I guess we'll both give our definitions and then I guess get into the conversation. So
what are we defining as a high value man?
That's the point, right? That's the whole point of the conversation because I feel like... okay, People were so upset at me when I did my whole hypergamy video because they were like, oh my God, like, well, but you know, men have to take care of us and thought. And I'm like, that makes no sense because at that point you're looking for men that don't really exist. Like there's not many men that can realistically take care of you. You have to be able to take care of yourself, find a man that can level up with you, not find a nigga that's like making trillions of dollars and that's the only reason you want him, whatever. But nonetheless, I was like, don't bait a bum, but people were upset, whatever. But I was also like, realistically, when you really think about it, for real, a high-value man could be so much different things. Like, some, like, say if there's, like, a girl in the hood, right? And she never had nothing. She never had a dad. She just had bare minimum. Maybe she's lived a hard life. So, adult, like, maybe the kingpin is high-value to her. Like, he the top of the food chain.
In her community, yeah.
In her, exactly. But it's like, to us, it's like, that is bottom of the barrel. So, it's like, damn, now I thought about it. I was like, I think high value is actually.
I like to focus on characteristics. I feel like a high value man, I don't even like saying high value man anymore.
I'm tired of that
like
word.
People are taking the term and they're running with it and turning it into something that is not. I feel like a high value man is just a man with integrity. Like, he's going to do right by you when you're not around. Or if he does make a mistake, he's going to own the mistake. He's going to come to you apologetic about the mistake that he made because that's in your best interest. That's in your well-being. So when I define high value, I'm looking for a man that is of quality. And the first characteristic that I'm looking for is integrity because we can't expect for people to be perfect first. Right. And then secondly, even if they do make a mistake, they're still going to do right by you in the midst of that mistake or mistake.
Very
but listen, repeated behavior, if it's trash, it's trash. You probably need to move on. But if it's like a one-time thing, and depending on what the situation is, he's still going to do right by you regardless.
This is very true. I always see people say, you know, high value means rich, high value means possessions. But what y'all need to understand on some real shit is there's so many rich men that aren't even that rich. They're rich, but they lifestyle poor. Okay. They sit in here, they might be making $1 million or whatever, but in actuality, that $1 million is probably $500,000 because of debt, because of expenses, because of God knows what else, because of the 10 kids he hiding from you. You feel me? Like, y'all be sitting there like, oh, rich is money. No, it's not. Rich is values. Rich is morals. Rich is knowing who you are as a person and where you're going in life. Rich is being taken care of. Like, you know how many men I know that don't make, let me see, they probably make 100K or maybe a little less, but you know what it is? They take care of their business. You know, they take care of their family. They know what they want to do in life. They know where they're going. They hold you up as a female. They complete you as a female. They take care of their whatever. So it never, like, it always baffles me when women will sit there and be like, oh, men ain't shit, man ain't da, da, da. And I'm like, okay, that's interesting. And then they try to, they tell me about the dude, like, oh my God, girl, I got play. He was driving a Benz and he was making 500K and da, da, da. But he...
Let me just put my two cents in, okay? Mm-hmm. I ain't gonna lie. I was one of those girls, okay? I literally thought if he had a blue check mark and he drove a nice car and he had a nice place, that he wouldn't be dusty. That is a freaking lie. And I tell girls this all the time. Why? Because some of these people be trying to live above their means. So if you're trying to live above your means, even though you're in a higher tax bracket than me, right. If you're living above your means within the tax bracket that is above me, right. You're broke.
Right. It's very true. Very true.
We can stunt all day, but like that's all we can do. We still got to go home and Netflix and chill because you broke. You ain't got no money.
No, you're absolutely right. Like, I genuinely can never understand. Like, people will sit there like, oh, I have a high value man. But then they describe the man. And I'm like, I don't understand how this is high value. And I would sit there and be like, this is materialistic garbage you're telling me now. Right. Like, this is absolute, like, junk. Like, this is not a man. Like, this is a, you know what I call them? A sheep, okay? A sheep in wolf's clothing. Because they're literally disguising themselves to be something that they're not. Like, you know how annoyed I used to be when I was single? Oh, my God. When I was single, I used to be so mad because there'd be these men. And you, girl, I know you know what, Yanni. You already know. Those men that just flash everything they got as soon as they meet you. They don't want you to drive their car. They don't want you to drive your car because they want to pick you up in their car. Because they want to show you that they drive in a Rolls Royce or whatever. They don't want you to pay anything. They don't want you to do... They just... Oh, look at my Versace. Look at my Gucci belt.
Oh, my God. Look at my... Oh, my God.
these men, like, I don't care. Yo, I got in a whole argument with this one dude because, like, I was barely interested. But you see, back in the day, I had this whole thing where I used to think with my mind, okay? If y'all watch my old videos, I was big as shit because I used to like to eat, okay? I love to eat. And I would take any nigga that would give me meals, okay? I used to be like, give me food. I don't care. Now, I learned to stop doing that because it got to a point where I'm like, if I'm not interested in you, I'm not accepting not a damn thing. Like, I don't care. And that was because this one dude, he tried to take me somewhere and I was like, okay, let me pay my half. And he was offended. Like, yeah. He was ready to fight me. And he's like, I got all of this money and rah, rah, rah. I was like, yeah, let me pay my half. Like, and as we're doing this at the register. Like, the person sitting there behind the register, he's like,
listen, I've even had a guy do this. Okay, when we first met, no jury, but I knew he had money because of his status, but there was no jury in sight. Like, he was like a regular looking guy.
Yeah.
When he was trying to impress me, this man wore a chain. It was huge. I was so turned off. And what he didn't understand was the main reason that I was attracted to him was because I'm like, oh, I like him. He's not flashy. I really like him. Like, he seems so down to earth. Da, da, da. Then when he tried to impress me the next time we saw each other,
right,
it was this big chain. I'm like, what did I say? I thought you were regular. I thought you were normal. Like, I thought you weren't flashy.
That happened to me.
A lot of these girls get impressed by that type of stuff. And I'm just like, I'm not impressed by that. I was actually impressed by you the first time.
They really do. I've seen it. Like, a lot of people will tell me, like, oh, well, I need to get this car because the bitches. I'm like, first of all, why are you trying to pick up a bitch? Second of all, why is that your ultimate goal? Third of all, don't tell me this shit again because I'm going to rip you to shreds. Like, I used to be sitting there like, why is that what y'all like? But then again, it's like a lot of girls, this is what they care about. So I get it. But it's like, why is that what y'all here for? Like, even like females, you know, males, females, why is that thing?
They be like, oh my God, like, all you guys care about is bags and da-da-da, but it's like, how did you get her to begin with? How did you will her in? How did you impress her? Did you impress her with the things that you have? Or did you impress her with good conversation? Did you impress her with paying attention to the small details about her? Or did you just wear a chain? You know, you're going to impress a certain type of woman with that.
Yeah, so it's all about what you attract. It really is. Like, if you're putting out that energy of, oh, I got this, I got that, I could give you this, I could give you that, be prepared to always give you this and always give you that. Like,
these chains are tacky. Somebody said chains. They are so chains are tacky.
Honestly, they really are. Like, if it's like a little baby chain, like, I didn't even put my little chains out. See, that was the whole part of the little aesthetic. See, my little baby chains. Like, if it's something like this. Whatever, but like, people be out here trying to wear like, chains bigger than
chains and with diamonds. It's just like, listen, I'm not trying to get robbed with you. Oh my God,
bro, they trying to get us killed. I do not want to ride with no This one dude I used to talk to, right? He was I'm gonna say he's a rapper, but I'm not gonna say what kind of rapper because people might figure it out. The point is,
being a rapper.
Something like that. The point is, dude pulled up to me. I didn't know who he was. He was one of those rappers that people know, but I clearly didn't know because I didn't really care. I don't pay attention to a lot of stuff, especially when it comes to like this new age music situation. All I listen to is Haitian music. I'll tell you this right now. Like, a lot of this new music, I don't listen to it unless I'm in the mood unless I'm lit. Like, So I meet up with him. He looked regular, just like how you said, regular. And then all of a sudden, he got gold in his hair. He got chains upon, like, three chains. He had a nice little car or whatever. I was like, I met you and you look so regular. It's just, it's so weird. I'm like, ooh, I'm so happy my man now is not like that. Like, he got so many, like, all his designer, you would never know his designer because he don't got prints on it. Like, he don't buy no designer with prints. He don't buy anything with the logo on it. He's just like what I like and that's it. I hate a flashy dude. Flashy dudes annoy me. Like, a flashy dude will, like, turn me off into boy vibe. Like,
can I explain why? Like, if there are any men on here, let me explain to you why it's a turn off. It's because sometimes I feel like men who are flashy like that, they put their identity in the things that they have that makes them feel complete. So, yeah. For me, that's what I look for. I'm like, oh, so, like, you don't feel like you have confidence now that you're trying to impress me. Maybe you were feeling me out the first time we met up. Mm-hmm. And so now you're trying to impress me. And so you have to use this chain, or you have to use this car, or you have to use this particular shirt to make yourself feel confident in order for you to be able to approach me or impress me. And I feel like that's whack. And I feel like it's very weak. And I feel like you really don't have anything beyond surface level. So I'm not interested. Like, I will lose interest after that.
I'm the same way. I can't stand it. I mean, like, I feel like, honestly, I actually started putting pieces together in my head as to why a lot of, especially Black men in particular, do this. It's not even, I think it's a Black people thing, especially if you're from a deprived type of neighborhood or deprived type of background. If you grew up in the hood, you grew up not having shit. When you have shit, you the shit. Even if you still live in the hood, right? Like, if you can show niggas that, like, you worth something, like, you got the Gucci chain, you got the, what called, everybody in the hood got a BMW or a Mercedes, and they always got the cheapest class. like, let's be real here. They got cars they can't afford, chains they can't, like, it, come on. And a lot of it is a status symbol, right? It's like, when you don't have it, you want to have it. Even though your bills might not be paid, but you're going to get respect for having these clothes. You know, your priorities may not be together, but at least you're going to have something. People are going to look to you in a certain type of way if you have this designer, if you have this car, if you have this B.I. Okay, I don't want to say bitch no more. Actually, I'm still going to say bitch. If you got this bitch, okay? Like, if you have that type of girl, or if you have that type of status, if you have that type of material, it kind of propels you in hood status. Niggas not going, well, niggas might rob you depending on what type of hood you from. Let's be real here. They might rob you. Like, that's why I could never understand the logic of trying to make it look like you have something that you don't, because you want to get robbed. But if you can somehow get it to the point where, like, niggas respect you because they afraid of you because you will shoot their house up, and here you got the chains and stuff like that, it's a win-win, because it's like, people are just going to leave you be. You know, they're not, like, if you have designer, it's like, you in a whole nother, it's like, you hood rich. You know, you hood rich. You not on everybody else's level. It's kind of like that whole thing that's going on right now. Like, I don't know if you've seen these videos of the I'm not like other girls trend. It's the same concept of basically trying to propel yourself to, like, oh, I'm not like other girls because I like video games. I'm not like other girls because I don't wear makeup. I'm not like
that bored in quarantine where we coming up with dumb challenges.
Apparently, this whole I'm not like other whatever trend has been a thing forever. It's the pick me girl thing. It's the same thing. It's essentially a hybrid of the pick me girl. The people that try to act like they so much better than everybody else that they're whatever. So they try to, oh, well, I'm better than you because this is what I do. And a lot of men engage in this behavior. They're the whole, well, I'm not like these other niggas because look at my Rolex. That's clearly fake, because a Rolex, I will never be able to fucking afford a Rolex ever in my life. I don't care how much money I make. A Rolex is so expensive.
can we talk about how these influencers be whack in person? Because they don't have their followers with them. They don't be having they likes with them. It's like, who are you, bro? Like, no shade, but, like, I've gone out with a few. I'm like, well, who are you? Why are you so boring? Like, I thought you were, like, cooler than this.
Bro, they boring, they fake, and most importantly, they ugly as all hell without makeup. I hate to be that bitch. I really do. But I'm going to just say this right now. A lot of y'all influencers that you think is the baddest, they look bad, all right? Like, first of all, this is why this collab right here, probably, I could count on maybe one hand how many people I've collabed with that weren't influencers, right? I mean, that are influencers. I collab with the same people. Like, that's it. Because niggas get me mad. Influencers are probably some of the worst people I've ever met in my entire life. Okay? Instagram influencers being the worst than YouTube. YouTube comes at a close second.
Every time I go to LA, I be like, I work in sales and advertisement.
I went to LA once and I was begging to come back to Newark. Like, I was like, bring me my potholes. Just bring me. I don't want to be here. Like,
I don't like it.
The fakeness. You could feel the fakeness. You could smell it. You could feel it. It's just so fake. And then the people are just, yo, oh. Like, it's really bad. It's really bad because it's like, these people swear they shit don't stink. But it's like, you reek.
You know what I don't like? I get stereotyped to be superficial or like one of them.
Yeah, I thought you were. I ain't even gonna lie to you.
I'm like, wait, this is fake. And I don't do fake. Like, my eyes start to twitch and then I feel real awkward. I don't even know how to be myself. I'm like, well, damn.
Listen, when I first heard of you, I was sitting there like, I'm not impressed. I don't care. I had to watch your content. It's crazy. You can't judge a book by its cover because I had to watch your content. I was like, I'm not. No, I don't see it. I don't see it.
That's real, though. Like, who cares? That's real. And people want to be so fake nowadays.
Yep.
All you have to do is be yourself.
People they don't do that in LA. Like, they're allergic to each other.
I hate it. And everyone's like, you should move there. Like, you have the look. No, right. I don't have the personality, people.
No. Yo, you know how many people be like, why don't you live in LA? And it's like, for what?
What?
What is in LA? What is in LA besides the devil? Like, I kid you not, I can't. The energy there is annoying. I just don't care for it. I don't like it.
Three times, it's not for me. I mean, it's not for me. I need to be around people that's gonna say what's really on their mind and not like tiptoe around the situation. I don't like it when people do that. I just don't like when people. Like,
very, very true. Now I feel you. Yeah, lots of fakeness. But I guess let's go back to that because I forgot. What was we talking about? Okay, the high value man thing. So what? When it comes to high value men, right? I feel like a lot of people always want to know, like, where do you find them? Like, I've seen so many videos, like, where do you find high value men or where to find a great man? I just be sitting there like, y'all really trying to give niggas advice to where to find a fucking high value. You're not gonna find a high value man because high value men ain't loud.
No, they not.
They not loud. They not going around trying to tell you that they're high value. They're not going around trying to scream to the heavens that they're good men. They're just good men that come into your life.
I'm like, you should just go volunteer and do some community work. You'll find somebody easy.
Yeah, people, community work. Just regular shit.
Go do some community work. Yep. Go to a fundraiser.
Yep.
Just do something within your community.
Bruh, like, go to the library. Like, just community events. Like, there's so many ways. But my thing is, it's like, you would never know. These not niggas in Gucci and Balenciaga when they can't pay their credit card. It's really not. Like, you
balances because they got to have them good shoes for their good feet because, you know, they be working hard. Mm-hmm. They just be regular people.
Mm-hmm.
Regular people.
That's what they always say. You know how they always say the richest people always look the most simple?
Yeah.
It's very true. Like, and that's not even, like, even though I really don't equate it to money, you have to be doing something of substance, right? So for all of y'all, please don't think that we just sitting here talk about some go date bums, go be with bums. That's not what we're saying. We're saying the person has to have integrity and values and morals in order to be deemed a good, you know, a good man or a high value man. I'm tired of that word. But I had to put that in there because I know that's what people would fucking recognize. But realistically, it has a lot to do with who you are as well. I feel like a lot of females, like a lot of women, a lot of females, a lot of girls, and that's another problem, the girls situation. A lot of girls be like fucking 16, 17, talk about some, I want a high value man. Like, bitch, you not even high value yet. Like, you barely got your period yet. Relax. Like, you don't need no high value man. You need a high value book. Like, y'all need to stop. Like, they be sitting there like, oh, these boys ain't shit.
Of course they're not.
Yo, honestly, let me tell you this right now. If you're in a relationship before the age of 25, honestly, rarely will you find a man that's like maybe 21, 23-ish, 24, that may be 100% faithful and is about they shit and is about you. But right. If the man is under 25, expect him to cheat or just be horrible.
And no, they be doing they be going after the dusties. Listen, if you want to get a high value man when you're in high school, you need to go after that nerd that be in the back of the class.
Yeah, you're gonna have to go after the dusty. I said the dusty. The nerd in the back, or yep. You're gonna have to just wait out your poison and date
dudes. Every woman should know this. Every high value man that became a high value man, he had to transition and transform into
that. Yeah, go for the third, if anything.
Don't be going for the most popular guy in your school. Like,
no, they always end up fat and ugly after high school, after college.
Go after the guy that is so, like, into, like, all the non-popular stuff. Like, he's not in, like, he lacks the socialization or whatever. Yep. Like, after him, the quiet one. Because he's going to blossom one day. And when he blossoms, you know, he's gonna be making bank. He's gonna be making bank, and you're gonna wish you went after that one instead of the popular guy that got like three baby mamas after high school. That's exactly how it is. So
that is exactly what it is.
Please understand that high value man, they go from being dusty to graduating to becoming a high value man. So play your cards right.
And then on top of that, I feel like a lot of these like people are just immature. And I feel like a lot of people mistake immature for ain't shitness. Like, I know damn well I've done a lot of ain't shit shit. Okay. There's a lot of guys to this day, I feel bad. Like, damn, I played you. Like, and they probably talking so much shit about me. Like, shawty played me. Shawty dot dot. And it's like, I did. I'm sorry. I apologize. But sometimes it's all about immaturity. Like, some people just didn't grow into their full selves yet. Some people didn't grow to that point where they are able to be that man or that woman that you need them to be. Ooh. I feel like a lot of times, like, we just be, like, dating somebody when we're, like, 20, 21. And then we get into a horrible situation. We're like, oh, my God, they're so horrible. And we 50 years old, still mad about that shit that they did when they 20, 21. But it's, like, in actuality, you didn't wait for them to grow up. They not there yet. Like, they not there yet. Like, honestly, I can say.
Some of them will never get there, y'all. Some of them will never get to where you feel they could have gotten.
Ooh, child. I ain't even gonna lie. I was a horrible, like, 22-year-old. 21, 22. Live.
That's what you're supposed to be. And then that's what like with social media, all these younger women be trying to be perfect. I'm not saying you need to be perfect. Like, get your dumbness out the way, because that's what we did. We had to get all our dumbness out the way. But eventually, when you get to a certain age, it's dumb starts to become stupid. Okay. Yeah. Dumb starts to become stupid. Dumb is when you don't know better, but you're learning, and that's when you transition from, okay, this is no longer dumb. Okay, me doing this now is just flat out stupid because I know better.
I feel like you also got to find yourself as well, because I feel like a lot of girls feel like, you know what, a lot of people might feel so upset, but I have to say this. A lot of women, girls, whatever, y'all be looking for fathers instead of boyfriends. Y'all want this man to do everything for you. You want him to pay your bills. You want him to fuck you good. You want him to feed your ass. You want him to wipe your ass. But then you are just you. You don't do nothing. You make mistakes all damn day. All you do is bitch, cry, complain. You don't want to change yourself. You don't want to go to school. You don't want to go to work. You don't want to do nothing. But then when a dude try to call you out on it, when a dude want to tell you that you're not on his level, whatever the case may be, all of a sudden, oh, niggas ain't shit. Come on, bro. We need to do better.
Listen. I have two brothers, okay? I have two brothers. So I've seen both sides. I feel like this generation, when it comes to dating, is just flat out trash, period. Bro. I'm with the same-sex couples as well when it comes to lesbians. It's just like people are just trash nowadays. Like, they dealing with things, they got issues, and they're not really, like, healing from them.
You got to heal yourself. You have to heal yourself before you be with anyone, even if the person's a dusty, because you're going to have more dusty problems, okay? From high value to dusty, you got to fix yourself, bro. Listen, when you don't know yourself on some real shit, when you don't know yourself, you don't know where you're going as a woman, when you don't know who you are, dead ass, you make relationships harder, and people don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear that shit. They want to hear, oh, well, I want to fuck. And I'm living my life. Live your life. Don't come to me. You know how many of my friends be trying me with that shit? Oh, well, I know I didn't listen to you, but this is what happened. I'm like, don't tell me what happened, because I told your dumb ass. I told your dumb ass that you need to heal. You need to stay by yourself. You need to live your life by yourself for a little bit.
I can honestly say I don't have friends like that. I think I got rid of all of them.
A few. Well, not a few. Maybe a couple. I cut off a lot of them because they started giving me a headache.
Yeah. Drama in my life. It's drama and it's draining. And it's just like, bro.
It's drama. It's draining.
If you're not learning from your mistakes, I can't be friends with you, because you're not about to suck me in your darkness.
And then they get mad. You ever had friends that, like, when you tell them straight up, like, what they're doing wrong, and they get, like, automatically upset, and now they want to fight, or, like, now they're just like...
I have the type of friends that know, okay, I'm going to go to Kiana, because she going to tell me what it really is, and then if I want a sugar-coated response, she going to go to somebody else. Don't come to me asking for advice, because I don't know how else to give it to you other than
what
it
is.
Straightforward.
I honestly, this is what I do, right? When it comes to relationship issues, I don't want to hear it. I believe that people need to keep their relationship problems to themselves. I believe that people should deal with their relationships behind closed doors. And that's another reason why I feel like a lot of people can't keep a relationship. They want to go run and tell their homeboys, go run and tell their homegirls, go run and tell their mama, any and everything that's going on. And then they're confused. Ooh. They're confused. Oh my God, my relationship is in shambles. That's because the whole fucking neighborhood is in your relationship. So why are you coming to me? Okay, you feel like he ain't shit. You feel like he doesn't care about your feelings. You feel like the dick is trash. Go tell him. What am I going to do? What am I, like, I get so mad. So then, first of all, I tell them straight up, don't tell me. But of course, niggas don't listen to me until it's too late. So they'll still tell me. And then I tell them what to do, or I'll give them my advice. But I always ask, do you want the Ivana advice, or do you want the what everyone else is going to tell you so you can help make the decision that you already know you're going to make, but you want people to validate type of situation? Because at this point, you know what you want to do. If you're going to ask someone, hey, do you think I should break up with him? You know what the right answer is. So at that point, don't tell me, because I'm going to tell you the same shit. And then I'm going to curse you out for wasting my time.
Like, don't. If you don't want no real advice, don't come to me.
Yeah, don't come to me.
I grew up in a household full of boys. My daddy is a straight shooter. So I'm a straight shooter. So if you come to me asking for advice, I'm going to give you the advice that I would give myself. And it's real, because I like to keep it real with myself as well. Not just with people. I have to
keep it real with everybody.
So when I give out my advice, understand, if I was in your shoes, that's exactly what I would do. People don't like it when I do that, but I'm like, listen, don't come to me for advice if you don't want the raw.
Because
it's gonna help you.
And then there's a difference between like you asking for advice and then you asking me to listen. Like sometimes my friends will come to me like, hey, I want to vent. And you know what I do, to be honest? Sometimes, I'm not even gonna lie, sometimes they know this. Okay, I know some of them are in this live right now. Y'all be irritating me, and I tell y'all this. Like, I just listen, I'll edit. I'll be like, all right, you want to vent? Mute. Because what are you venting for? Like, go to the therapist. Y'all don't pay me enough for this. Like, this is wild. Like, I just be sitting there like, why are we talking about this again? You still ain't leave that in.
They be coming to you for advice because they know you are going to give the tune like straight.
But then they get mad at the advice. It don't make sense. It's like, but you're mad at the advice, and then 2-3 months later, you're like, Ivana, you were right. And I'm like, about what this time? Because I think I've had a good track record with being right. So which one am I right about now? Because at this point, you know, it's just ridiculous. Like sometimes you just have to fix yourself. You have to be self-aware in order to get the person you need in your life. You got to be able to tell yourself like, hey, I ain't shit, or damn, I need to get my life together, or I need to start loving myself more.
Saying you ain't shit, I've done it. Like, I've been where you are. And that's another thing. It's like people act like because you're the one giving advice that you're perfect. Listen, I'm giving you advice from what I went through.
Right. So
please, you can. That's where it's coming from. Like, I can't give you the advice if I didn't go through it.
Right. Oh my God, guys, hold on. I just did something. Don't pay attention to the mess I just did. Oh my God, the mess. What did I do? Okay, there you go. My bad, guys. But yeah, it's just ridiculous at this point. It's come to a point where I'm just like, I feel like a lot of this should be common sense, especially when it gets to when you get to a certain age. But it's not.
I'm learning common sense is not so common no more.
It's not. I feel like as we get older, people get worse. People get worse. Like, I be literally giving advice to old ass women like in their 40s. And I'm like, why are you asking me? Like, shouldn't you be giving me advice?
Some of them lack guidance. Like, some of them don't have people in their corner pushing them to do better. Like, they have people enabling their poor decisions and behavior. I'm learning that with just mentoring. Like, some people don't have people in their environment that wants more from them. They just expect bare minimum. And it's like an enabling factor as well, because it's not requiring them to do better. It's just requiring them to do exactly what they've been doing. Nothing. They don't want to improve. They don't want to do any of that. And they don't have people in their corner wanting them to do that. They're like, well, we really didn't expect for you to do more than what you're doing.
Yeah, absolutely right. I'm actually slowly realizing, and I think that's probably something that's going to be the hardest for me to grasp, that the common sense is not common. Because, like, sometimes I just be saying certain things, and I'm like, wouldn't it be common sense for y'all to just go look it up? And people just don't. And I'm starting to see it everywhere. It's like, wouldn't it be common sense to just leave that girl? wouldn't it be common sense to just leave that dude? And I'm like, okay, clearly it's not. No. It's so weird. It's so weird. Like, people need to really learn how to take accountability. Until you're able to be accountable for your actions, for real, you're not going to be able to find that high value anything, okay? Even a high value woman. I feel like this goes for women too. Okay, don't think that this is just
a thing. What is a high value woman? What is a high value woman?
I believe it's the same thing. A woman that has values and morals and knows where she's going in life. A woman that doesn't have to do shit for the attention of others, does things for themselves and the betterment of themselves, but in the same regard, is not a bum.
Listen, majority of women today do things for attention.
Oh my God. They don't want to talk about that, Yanni. We can't talk about that. We're going to be canceled. We don't talk about
it because it's the truth.
We're going to be canceled.
I mean, it's a trend. It's literally a trend to do things for attention. It's literally a trend.
They don't want to have that conversation. They don't want to have that conversation.
We literally got girls in fake relationships getting dogged out by a guy, potentially putting her at risk for STDs and all type of other sexually transmitted diseases. But she gonna stay with him because she likes the attention and clout that she gets.
Yeah.
Are you even kidding me?
Yeah, it happens. And honestly, that's why I don't take these people serious. Like, these rappers, these actors, these whatever everybody looking up to, and they wanna, oh, well, they're this. They make excuses for all their actions. Like, please understand that if you do what they're doing, your ass is gonna be out on the street. Literally.
Fired, like, 1 or 2, fired. You gonna lose your job.
You're going to lose everything to some Dusty. Like,
and it's all to get attention from Dusties. Dusty-ass niggas. Girls be on Instagram be like, oh my God, like, I want to be like the Instagram model. Listen, I used to do that, okay? It's stupid. I was so thick into that body positivity, Instagram model, Instagram baddie things. It's so dumb. Like, you
body
literally...
Wait, hold up. That's body positivity? Getting a BBL is body positivity.
I was doing it for body positivity. Seriously, because seeing a girl with my height, seeing a girl that was curvy. Yes,
wait, how tall are you?
5'10".
Oh my God. I'm 4'11". You would be like towering me, bitch. Like, what?
So, like, for me, it really was.
Man, you and Eloho about biggest shit, bro. What the fuck?
We are like being a taller woman. It's like, okay, you don't really see that. You only see tall girls that are skinny. You never see the tall girls that are, you know, thicker. So for me, it was. But I'm not gonna lie. I was playing into my sexuality as well. But when you do that, you are attracting dusty ass niggas. You're literally attracting men with blue check marks that really are broke because they living above their means. They may be able to fly you out, but they can't fly you back home. So it's just like, why do you want to attract men like that? Why do you want to attract men like that? And then another thing is like, they may be-
Wait, hold up. You said they can't fly you home.
They can't fly you home. They can fly you there. They can't fly you back.
You know what? You ain't had to do that. You ain't-
Listen, you'll get all this attention just to attract a bum. Like, you're literally getting all this attention to attract a bum.
No, you're absolutely right. Like, these dudes with this whole fly me out and this whole whatever. The, I don't even know what the fuck.
You want to be a baby mama? Okay, sign. That's what you're signing up for, is to be a baby mama.
They want to be a baby
mama. I just post selfies. I don't even post my body anymore. I'm just going to post some selfies.
Yeah.
Hopefully with my selfie, if I get the right angle or something, I can catch me a high value man. But my body is going to, it's going to attract dusties. Dusty, 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 dusty.
Yeah. It does.
So to all the girls that are on here, you think that's what you need to do, sis? If you really want a high quality man, I don't even like saying high value. Want a quality man? I wouldn't do it. I would not do it. Why? You're gonna attract a dusty man. Dusty. You're not. And you just understand marriage. If that's something that you want, you could throw that out the window.
Yeah, it's true. It's very true. I had an argument with some, let me not say that word. I had a value with some idiot on Twitter a while ago. And basically I was like, y'all doing all this whole shit and expecting to get wifed. You ain't gonna get it. This bitch had the nerve, the god audacity to talk about something. Oh, well, I've seen plenty of hoes get married. I said, and how many of them crying, bitching, and complaining about getting cheated on every other day? How many of them have quality niggas?
You have to understand, if you want a traditional man, you need to carry yourself in a traditional manner.
Low key, high key.
It ain't even, no, it's not low key. It's high key. It's as simple as that. It's
we have to panda to them.
Oh, hell low no. Keys.
No, you're right.
I prevent you from being a baby mama.
No, you're right. You're right. You do have to look.
If you want a traditional man, you need to carry yourself in a traditional manner. Point blank period.
You do. That's the price. And people want to throw that ass in a circle. They want to put their body all over Instagram, being naked all damn day and do whatever. Like, that's the thing. There's a difference between sexuality and wholeness. Period.
What is the difference? Explain that to me.
Okay, so when people were coming at Chloe, there was nothing wrong with that girl. There was nothing wrong with her. She looked gorgeous.
She was on that line, though. She was definitely straddling that line.
I didn't see it. I didn't see no straddle. Like, okay, first of all.
The Baltic challenge?
Okay, maybe. But the bitch is grind.
If it wasn't for the busted challenge, I'd be like, what's the problem? Like,
yeah, the busted challenge, I guess.
More so what she had on while she was doing it.
I don't think it was that serious compared to the fact that we have bitches walking around in bikinis like it's fucking normal, like it's regular attire, fucking dancing around and literally like nipple covers. So my thing is,
who is doing that?
A lot of these people's favorite rappers and singers. Let's look at these music videos. What these girls got on?
Oh, I stopped watching that stuff.
I did too because of that. My virgin eyes. It's like, nah, I ain't a virgin clearly, but
it's getting worse and worse and worse. Like, I can't even watch.
It is. It's getting really bad. It's getting to the point where, like, people are normalizing this behavior and people that are, like, regular and normal. And essentially, let's be real, doing things the right way are being overlooked, are being disrespected, are being clowned for being just regular people. Like, unless you have that Instagram body, unless you have a BBL, unless you got makeup caked up on your face 24/8, unless you got a 25-inch weave in your head, what else? Unless you look like an Instagram bitch, you're like not it.
But if you do look like the Instagram girl, baddie, whatever, just understand you're attracting a dusty ass nigga.
Most of the time. Most niggas don't want bitches that are like that in the first place.
What is that one girl that got her a good man from looking like an Instagram baddie? I'll wait.
I'm really trying to find one in my head. Hold up. Damn, I really can't think of one. I'm sure somebody in the comments gonna get one. No, I don't think there's one. Dang. Yeah, it's sad to think about. Like, a lot of us will sit here and like try to be like these girls. Like, I had my little phase where I was like, oh my god, I gotta do this, I gotta do that. And I was like, let me stop playing. I know damn well. Like, I do not care. I was like, yo, I even got sucked into it. I feel like we all had that moment of like.
Listen, name one. Just one girl.
Someone said Lori Harvey.
Her relationship is fake. Name one. That's a publicity stunt. I'm sorry if you didn't know. Now you know. It's fake. Okay.
Someone said African Beauty. I love her channel. But she doesn't look like an African Beauty.
See? But let me see how she like portrays herself.
She's great. She started out with a hair channel, a natural hair channel, and then now she does couple channel. The man just reports to her. I really like her, but I don't think she be wearing provocative clothes online and BBLing, and I don't think she does all of that.
Girl,
I feel like she covers herself well.
No, she does not.
Oh shit! You know what?
No, that ain't it.
You see, you have to do that. You better not have these motherfuckers sending this shit. Really noticed, like, I've subscribed to her for a while, but I haven't watched her stuff in a while. I came across the proposal recently on Twitter, but I've genuinely, I don't know what's on her shit.
Let me go look. Maybe I'm looking at the wrong page, but I'm like,
yeah, African Beauty, H-A-L-F freaking.
We talking about one girl.
Yeah, one girl, African Beauty. I'm surprised you haven't seen her channel. She's one of the bigger hair channels that transition. You know all the natural hair channels done fucking.
No, she is not. This is not what I'm talking about.
Oh, okay.
I don't see an ass picture yet.
Oh, someone said Saweetie.
Oh, and you mean the girl that her boyfriend don't want to marry her, so he like stringing her along. The last girl that he proposed to. We talking about that one?
Saweetie, yeah. I was about to say, like, isn't her nigga, like, stringing her along for a ring that she never gonna get?
YouTube beauty gurus. Y'all need to drop names.
Y'all need to stop.
Well, I can look up because I'm serious. I'm talking about married. I'm not talking about boyfriend, girlfriend. We gonna play
around. Oh, nah. Oh, okay. I mean, they're engaged.
That's good.
You know what? I ain't playing with you.
There's not one, ladies. That's my point. If it's not one, if your end goal is marriage, being an Instagram baddie ain't the way to go. Okay.
Oh my God.
Ugh. That's just the reality of the situation. Listen, I literally be having Instagram girls DM me about their rebranding status.
And oh, Jackie Ina. Someone said Jackie Ina.
But she don't post her ass.
She don't. So that's a good one. We got one, Jackie Ina. That's good. Perfect. Thank God. I think that's all we got. Cause now all these YouTubers getting fucking divorced.
I know.
That shit, yo, pandemic fucked a lot of people's relationships.
I know. Which is insane. Bruh. Don't use Cardi B.
Someone fucking said Natalie Nunn next. Bye. All right. We're off the topic.
Natalie Nunn is currently cheating with the producers of, what's that production company? Is it called Zeus?
I think it's Zeus. Zeus Network.
He's cheating with the producer to get on. Cardi B is probably getting cheated on. She keeps rearranging her face because, you know, when she did a song saying, oh, now he got me in the mirror looking at myself different, like I'm insecure. Remember when she said that? And now she's getting all this plastic surgery done. Those are not good examples at all. Susan is like the only one I can really think of, but she don't be posting that type of stuff. And you notice how Susan never did the busted challenge.
Oh, God. I never thought about that.
Susan never did the busted challenge.
I don't got time for none of these challenges. I got more volume. My nigga would look at me like, excuse you. My man would never. My man.
How do you feel? And then this is another thing. How do you feel about men being territorial over what you put on social media that is considered to be sexual?
Do you feel like that
is controlling, or do you feel like it's a respect thing?
I think it's a respect thing because I don't want my niggas dig all over the internet. So
that's what I said.
Like, I don't think it's that serious. Like, my boyfriend won't sit there like, don't fucking post it. But he will probably give me a look like, you're going to post that?
Right.
Like, he'll give me a look, or he'll give me a, oh, like, okay, perfect example. When I did that, I don't know if you've seen it, but I posted a picture maybe a month or so ago from a collab for Tavi Noir. It was like a fitness brand, and I had like this sports bra thing with leggings. My boobs are big. I can't do nothing about that. Like, I have a chest. It don't matter if I wear a turtleneck. You're going to see that I got like a D cup. Like, and I'm little. So it's there. And I sent him the pictures beforehand because I didn't want it.
No, you don't do that.
First of all, the picture did well. Like, the picture did well. But, like, he was like, so they gave you the bra thing too? I was like, yes. Everything down to the socks. Like, everything is sponsored. He's like,
he's doing a sponsored content.
It is sponsored. It's not like I was wearing a bikini for my life. Like, I mean, bikini. I was wearing the sports thingy with the leggings for the sponsor. Okay, so I was like, yeah, this is what it is. And he didn't say don't post it. He wasn't catching attribute. He was just like, okay. I'm like,
listen, if you really want to be taken serious, how you put yourself out here, it matters.
No, it really does.
Listen, I love Kayla Nicole. I love Kayla Nicole, okay?
Who's that again?
But she dates Travis Kelce. I love her to death. But this man will not marry her, y'all. And I want to know why. I want to know why.
Oh, Patricia Bright. That's a good one.
That's a good one. Patricia, but she doesn't post bad content. It's more family-oriented.
Yep, see? So that's a good one. There you go. She got a good nigga.
I'm talking.
Oh yeah, wait, we're talking about the niggas that post provocative content,
right? And get a healthy relationship or marriage.
I can't think of one.
I can't think of one at all. Like, that's People get mad at me, but I'm just like, we're looking at the facts here, okay?
Yeah, the fact of the matter is, if you are going to post that type of content, if you're going to push yourself out that way, you're not going to find someone of high value. That's not even because, oh, hey, Paris, that's definitely a good example.
It is.
Yup. Hey, Paris. Oh, my God. Wow. Huh?
But yeah, she doesn't even, oh, she rebranded. She rebranded herself. Okay, sis.
She rebranded herself to what? She don't still tell stories?
No, she used to. She used to. But she rebranded herself. Like, she don't even have that many pictures. She got married.
Yeah, she got married. She's been with that
man. Did y'all see how the girl rebranded herself on Instagram? She, like, deleted majority of her photos.
I'm not even gonna lie. Yeah, she did used to have way more photos than that. You're absolutely right.
So, that's what I'm saying. Like, how you present yourself on social media, regardless if you agree or not, it matters.
Someone had the nerve to say De'Ara and Ken. The same Ken that been fucking cheating and got caught twice and created a whole goddamn scandal. Y'all not about to say De'Ara and Ken. Y'all not. And plus, they're still engaged. I believe they're not even married yet. And he still put her.
We're trying to get you down the aisle, sis. We're not trying to get you halfway there. We're trying to get you down the aisle. To get you all the way at the altar. So
that's the thing. A lot of girls will never make it to the altar because they refuse to acknowledge that their behavior is most likely what's keeping them from the altar. Their behavior, their crave for attention, their ignorance of just self.
I'm not saying you can't get a man. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you're not going to get the high value.
Yeah, you get a regular man.
Everybody wants the one that provides. You're just not gonna get that.
Ah, someone said Beyonce. Didn't she get cheated on? Well, we don't have proof of that yet. Right? There's no proof of that.
Wow, Paris has been with him for 4 years. That's crazy.
Hey, Paris has been with that man for more than fucking 4 years. It's been a while. I've been watching Paris for like a very long time. She's been with that man for a minute. Like, it's been a good
night. I was on Delicious's.
Wait, hold up. Someone said Cosmoholics Anonymous. The same nigga that cheated on her with her subscriber. Did you miss that? If y'all don't fucking stop playing with me with these names, y'all just want me to go off. Y'all just want me to go off. Do y'all just want me to go off? He cheated on her with a whole subscriber, and she got back with him, and she pregnant again with the third baby for no reason.
Oh gosh.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Like, no. Like, she was cheated on.
The fact that we have to struggle to find a person should tell you enough.
Bruh, like, this man cheated on her with a subscriber, got an Airbnb to be with the bitch. She found the Airbnb, dragged a nigga on fucking Instagram, had to delete or block her Instagram because people kept coming at him. Now she only on Snapchat, came back to YouTube. It's a whole saga. So clearly, and someone said Nicki Minaj. First of all, Nicki Minaj's entire husband is a convicted. You know what? Y'all need to stop playing with me today. Maybe y'all just want me to get mad.
They desperate. They trying to find somebody. It's okay. It just proves my point.
Yeah, like Cosmoholics Anonymous got cheated on, and I'm sure there's more times behind closed doors. And then, like, I don't know how y'all don't know about this. Like, this shit was a saga.
I'm gonna just keep it all the way a stack. The only way a woman that can get away with it, the only way you can get away with it is if you white. I said what I said. If you a black woman, you're not going to get away with that shit. You want to know why? Because we have to deal with stereotypes, starting with the Jezebel. So if you're not a white girl, it's facts. It's facts. These little white girls, they be on the beach putting their little bum on the internet. Got a boyfriend, husband, and the whole nine. Got a whole, we talking about a whole trust fund, savings, a man with health insurance. It's different for us as black women. Like, you have to literally play chess. It sucks. It's the reality. It's the same thing with Sex in the City versus Girlfriends. I did a video on this. Sex in the City, they can have 50 to 60 sex partners. On Girlfriends, you can just be dating a guy, and they be like, oh, well, you know, they was hoeing around a lot on that show. I'm like, they were? No, was in a relationship with every man she actually had sex with. You talking about she a hoe?
You're so right.
So, yeah, it's different for us as black women. It sucks, but it is what it is, and you need to know what you're up against. And it's just, it is what it is. Even Sierra's changed her image. Sierra doesn't even put herself out there like that. Yeah. When you get a man in your life, it's just, you have to carry yourself differently. And it's like, women don't like that, but it is what it is. That's what you're up against.
You definitely do. And then when you have kids, it's a whole nother ball game.
Yeah.
It's a whole nother ball game. I feel bad for the bitches that was Instagram baddies and then had to change their image with their Instagram baddie photos still up there, and then their kids gonna grow up and be able to find those pictures.
Oh my God, I'm gonna do a video about this, but Caesar from Black Ink.
Oh my God, I love him.
His current girlfriend, the reason why she was pressuring him for this promise ring proposal, whatever the case was. Because
they're like pushing 50.
She's 33. I don't know how old he is.
Jesus, over 40.
She's like an ex video vixen. Like, if you Google her name, she has a photo of her whole top being exposed. So what I got from the situation is, this girl is trying to settle down. She changed her image back in 2018 based off of my research. She took on this realtor image. She tried to take on this more professional image. But she waited too long. She waited until she was like 28. So she's 33 now. And so now she's pressuring this man for marriage. The truth is always in the pudding. I keep telling y'all, the truth is always in the pudding. Listen, I'm trying to get you married, sis. I'm not white. You know how they say white. Listen, I'm trying to get you married. This girl is 33 years old pressuring Caesar from Black Ink to marry her.
Bro, I don't know. No, he's his track record. He's not about that girl.
Oh my, no, he's not.
I love C's. I watched him for years on Black Ink and all his relationships. Him and Ryan. Ryan Henry is like the love of my life. Like, I love him so much. But both of them, I love it. I love Ryan Henry so much.
Wow. I think he's trash, but okay.
Probably. I would never touch him in real life if I had the opportunity, because he's clearly garbage and he's suffering from a lack of inner child. However,
what is wrong with him?
Wait, a lot. There's a lot going on with him. he has a lot of grief from his sister passing along with her daughter. He hasn't dealt with that. I'm sure there's a lot of things from growing up in Chicago that he's dealing with. And he just has a really serious commitment issue going back and forth with the baby moms. Like, he has a lot. Like, both of them. But I bank on C's getting married before Ryan.
I do too. I can see that.
Because Ryan Henry really has a serious commitment issue. Like, it's to the point where it's like, all right, it's kind of getting childish at this point.
I can definitely see that.
It's getting real childish. Like, it's like, come on, at least just marry the baby mother since you're going back to her every fucking 6 months anyway. At this point, I believe that she's just, I mean, these girls, like the girl that's trying to get with whatever her name is, this the C's girlfriend, she's going to be gone in the next 6 months. Mark my words, they're not going to stay together because C's tends to run away from pressure and he don't like people telling him what to do. So we'll see how that goes. That's what's going to happen.
Tiana Taylor don't count because she was a tomboy before she took on this sex symbol. And the only reason why she took on this sex symbol is because she was being encouraged to by her production team. So that one don't count.
Aren't they the same ones that have that open marriage?
Yeah, and then they have an open marriage. So, like, that's not a good example. Not if it's only a good example if you're into non-traditional style relationships. If you're wanting a more traditional style relationship, totally different ball game. But if you're into the non-traditional, yeah, it could work for sure. They're sweet.
I personally will never in my life let my man sleep with another bitch.
I would stab somebody.
Yeah, I might.
I don't like sharing my food, so why would I like sharing my man? You know what
who
I'm
is
saying?
Naja Malat? I don't know who these people are that y'all bring up. Naja.
Listen, they gotta dig for people, literally.
Yeah, y'all digging for people for real, because I'm just sitting there like, what?
It should come right off the top of your head.
Yeah. Who's Delicious? We're talking about Delicious, like, from Flavor of Love? Yandy and Medici's. Isn't Medici locked up, or did he get out?
Wait, they're not even legally married. That one don't count either.
Wait, they're still not legally married?
No. And listen, that is a, I got money.
Michelle Obama doesn't put her ass on the internet. Do y'all not listen? We're talking about girls that put their ass on the internet and are inappropriate. Okay. Inappropriate women. Okay. Women that put their ass all online that have healthy relationships. Try again, y'all. Sorry. Go ahead, Yanni.
What was I saying? Wait. Michelle Obama, that's not a good one. That's not a good one at all.
Oh, Mendeecees. I didn't know Mendeecees was out.
No, Mendeecees and Yandy is a good example of what a struggle love with money relationship looks like. Okay? Stop it. Stop playing with me. Let that go. No talk. Like, that's some struggle love, I got money type situation.
Yo, that's that prison. Yo, that's Love After Lockup. You ever watch that show? That's literally Love After Lockup.
I will say this. I will say Miracle Watts, she straddles that thin line. She does. I like me some Miracle Watts, okay? I call her a brownie. She's sweet, okay? And she fine as hell. If I was gay, I would be gay for her. But she straddles that thin line. She straddles that thin line.
Wait, who?
Miracle Watts. Every time you see her in a bikini, she's on the beach.
I don't know who that is.
She's not in her bedroom.
Like, you said Miracle Watts? Mm-hmm. What kind of, that's an interesting name.
She's a Southern belle.
No, that's what it sounds like. Miracle now, Watts. Wow, I found her real quick. Oh, she's so cute. Oh, she's pretty.
She's very pretty.
Oh, you're really
cute. She'll either be selling something or something like that. But I think she is single as well, I think.
Yeah, I don't see
her going. Doesn't put her relationship on the internet.
Yep, like me. I probably got two pictures with my nigga. Be that set. I don't got time. Niggas need to mind their business. I got one vlog, finally. I did a video with my nigga before.
I can always tell when an Instagram model is in a relationship. She stopped posting those type of photos.
You can tell.
I can always tell. That's why I think she's in a relationship just offline, because she stopped posting those type of photos.
Yeah, let me see. Her last provocative type of photo was...
It was a minute.
It's not provocative. It says in February 1st. That picture's not provocative to me. That's sexy, not provocative. This is a birthday shot, so I think she got leeway. All right, let's keep showing. Okay, you're right. These aren't that bad. What the fuck? She's very cute. Where is she from? How'd she get famous?
I don't even know.
Ew. I might even follow her. It's hard to get a follow from me.
She currently lives in Atlanta, but like she moved from the South. I don't know what. Maybe she's from Georgia,
possibly. But what does she do? What is she? Like an actor?
She's just an Instagram influencer.
How do people just be you? Like, how does that happen?
She sells, she has her own clothing line.
Oh, must be nice. I'm like, who? Someone said Queen Naija, good night. The one with two baby fathers? She ain't married yet, relax. Oh, well, she was married, so that works.
Oh, she was.
That's she was married.
Married right now.
Yeah, Queen was married, and now she's with Clarence, and yeah.
Y'all need to look at the reality of these relationships that y'all see. It's not all glitz and glam like y'all think.
It's not. Someone said Sukiana. Good night. Y'all better stop it. that had to be the funniest response I think we've got. Sukiana.
Y'all trolling us.
Y'all, now y'all trolling us, bro. Y'all just want to record this shit and send it. Oh, Remy Ma. Well,
Remy Ma don't be posting herself like that.
She don't.
We're talking about provocative. We're not talking about I'm showing some skin. There is a difference.
Yeah, you're very right. Remy Ma. I loved Remy Ma. She could have been great.
I know. What happened?
Jail. That's not funny. But jail.
Dang.
Jail happened.
People seems to be doing good. I mean, considering everything.
Her life is interesting. She's not really into the music situation as much as she used to be. I'm sure she still posts music, but no one cares about it because, yeah, sad.
They got a nice house for her, for nobody to be interested in their music.
It's called Residuals. I'm sure she's still making money from I'm Conceited, I Got a Reason. I'm sure people are still bumping that somewhere. Somewhere in the dirty South.
And then she got 8.2 million followers. New York. Fine.
The fuck out of hell? Love and Hip Hop definitely did that. There's no way.
Yeah, I don't know how. That's what I was about to say. How did she get so many followers?
Like, even I love Remy Ma. I ain't following her. For what? Jessica Dime, good night. You know what? Now, y'all, Jessica Alba, Jesus. Okay, let me find this Naj Malat that y'all keep talking about. Because Naj Malat. I couldn't
find her.
Huh?
I could not find her.
Naj.
Married, y'all? We talking about married women.
Naj Malat. Okay, she's cute. Why do all these Instagram girls look exactly the same?
They going to the same doctor.
Yo, clearly. Let me see. 26-year-old, 50-year-old, Jean Malo. Oh, okay, so she is married. She's cute. The surgeries just look very surgery-like. That's the problem here. But she's very cute. Like, her boobs look really... Yeah, her boobs just look real... Not real. I don't want to... They just don't look good. Whoever did this surgery...
Oh, hold on. Let me see.
Yeah, that's all I got to say. But she's cute in the face. But then again, it could just... Oh, she got a white boyfriend that's like 80 years old.
But listen, she with a white man.
Yeah, that don't... Yeah.
I told y'all that don't count.
Yeah, that definitely don't count. She's a good example of, I guess, securing the bag, as we like to call it.
She's gorgeous.
Yeah, she's cute. She's cute.
Ooh, her boyfriend cute too.
That white man is not fucking cute. That nigga look like a wrinkled banana. If you don't fucking stop it.
What?
He look like an old banana. Like he
should have, I'm trying to see what his bank account look like, because it looked like his bank account is...
That's the only cute thing about it. Probably his bank account, because that nigga's face...
Wait a minute. You look good in this suit. I think his suit...
I'm looking at the same picture, bitch. Where? Her, like, that nigga is not cute. That nigga look like an old banana, bro. Y'all need to stop it.
We can really be friends in real life. I like how you don't got my taste.
Oh, I'm like, this nigga's not cute. They got her to be in the gym. Like, she can't just... You know what? I'm just going to shut up.
I could work with this. I could work with this. Okay, sis. I see. You know what? She going to get a follow for me.
I don't see it. Ew, this dude looks... Ugh. He seems to love her. They look like he actually looks like he loves her, though.
And he looks like he's in shape, too, for his age.
No, deadass. Deadass. They in the gym together in certain pictures. Like, okay. Okay. She looked like she'd be feeding him his Metamucil every day and shit. Like, this is cute.
Okay. Sis is out here winning. I'm here for this one. This was a good one. I don't know who recommended, but she's a good one.
Bro, they was typing her name forever, and I'm like, who? She's very cute, though. I don't know if I would follow her. Let me see. Would I actually care for this content? What did she do? Let me see how she got famous.
Did she do, like, workout videos or something?
I don't know. Co-founder of O Snap Active Life. I help transform minds, bodies, and bank accounts. Not the type of shit I want to follow. Hey, no, I'm good.
Listen, I'm liking her squat form, and I can use this.
Yeah, I mean, to be quite honest with you, like, yeah, okay, to be honest, I guess the takeaway here is high value or good men, high quality men are to be found by making yourself high quality, you know? You can't just...
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, you can't just be a regular, low value, posting your ass all up on the internet. You know, doing all things that you know damn well you shouldn't be doing and expecting men to, like, flock to you. And it's the same thing vice versa. Men, y'all can't be out here flashing y'all chains. Huh?
Listen, the men will come, but they gonna be dusty.
Yeah, they're not gonna be the type of men you want. Same thing, vice versa. Like, men, y'all can't be flashing y'all chains that y'all can't afford. And trying to act like y'all this, that, and the third, got no education, no life, no values, no integrity, and think that the right bitch is going to come to you. It's not us, it's you, for the most part. I'm not going to lie. A lot of times it is you. But even when it's not you, I feel like all of us need to work on ourselves before we go try to find any type of relationship. And I feel like a lot of people are just lazy. Like, a lot of people just don't want to work on themselves, and that's part of the problem.
I thought it was just me. I'm like, oh my God, why are y'all so lazy?
No, that's really what it is. Like, a lot of people don't want to work on themselves. They don't want to take accountability for the way they act. They don't want to actually admit that they are the way they are, or they're in their current predicament of misery because of themselves. A lot of people don't want to admit that, but that's exactly what it is. And until you guys can realize that, you're going to stay in the same motherfucking predicament, blaming other people but yourselves. You see, I always say this, and people, of course, are going to be mad at this, but black people are allergic to accountability. Not all, but a lot.
Why? Listen, I went to jail. I used to steal back in the day. People look at me like,
Yanni, you went to jail?
Yes, and I used to steal. I had a bad habit, okay? I'm just putting it out here so people could just understand, see the full picture. I used to steal back in the day. I had a bad habit, okay? And it was because I developed this bad habit.
What was you fucking stealing?
I was hanging out with this girl, right? And I thought it was cool to steal. And so then when I found out how easy it was, I'm like, oh, I can do this. Like, I really felt like I was smarter than everyone, you know? And so I used to steal. And then I'm like, when I got caught one time, I was like, I'm never doing that again. Like, I already went to jail once. I'm not trying to go back. So they let me off. When they let me off, I was like, I'm never stealing ever again, just because, like, it really developed this addiction. It was like this addiction, like, oh, I can take this, I can get this for free. Have you ever been in that addiction energy where you feel like, oh, I can just get it for free, why pay for it?
Yeah. When, you know, I accidentally stole from Walmart a couple times, like, damn, I need to do this for more. The fucking step, the fucking what you would call it, the self-checkout. Like, I sometimes it'd be so much going on, I'm like, oh shit, I accidentally took this.
I go through this and check out. I make sure I scan everything. I do not play when it comes to that anymore, just because I never want to be back in that energy of addiction, of feeling like anything I can take, you know, I can have it free. And you never want to be in that, like, mindset. So I got rid of that. What else? I used to date bums. Like, who didn't date bums? Like,
oh, I mean, we all have a bum or 10 in our repertoire.
Oh my God.
Amazing.
I have drug dealer stories and all type of stuff.
It yeah. Is I definitely have drug dealer stories.
I was reading the book, Coldest Winter Ever. And I'm like, I thought that was so cool. I'm like, oh, let me date a drug dealer. It's not no big deal.
I heard that book is about I was like, why are you reading? You wilding. Now, dating drug dealers, like, listen, I'm from the hood and my dumb ass still dated. Well, you know what? I can't even lie, because when I dated these drug dealers, they weren't game banging or drug dealing until after. So technically...
But I didn't even know until after the fact, until they, like, go to jail.
Yeah.
They calling you from.
Yeah, realistically, yeah. Like, for me.
Would you like to accept the call?
Yup. No, actually, I have one that literally was a drug dealer for years. Like, we was talking for years on and off. And then he had a trap phone. I have a whole story time on my channel about that. Ooh, child. Yeah, like, he had a trap phone, and then he had a regular phone, and then he tried to take me on a drug run. This is one of the main reasons I got a car. I would have never got a car if this man ain't take me on a drug run. So I guess I have something.
I didn't have a car. It's just not worth it. Like, if you take on that life, it's just going to lead you to a dead-end ditch. And you could be in the ditch.
That's no, seriously. Y'all want to date all these dope boys and these thugs and shit. That shit is not cute. And it's what's really not cute is when you getting calls at 3 o'clock in the morning hearing the nigga got shot. Or worse, killed.
Oh my
or God. Niggas, yeah, trust me. Or next thing you know, niggas knocking on your fucking door because they want to collect. And they hear at your house because they see that nigga in and out of your house because he pushing dope out of your house. That's what happened to a somebody. I'm not even going to say that because people are going to upset. But that's what happens to a certain somebody that we all know of.
What?
And it happens all the time. Like, y'all be out here wanting to fuck with dope boys, wanting to fuck with multiple dope boys at that, and be confused at the circumstances. Like, I don't understand.
I've seen girls get shot up.
Yeah.
It's not worth it. It's not worth it.
Yeah, y'all think this shit's sweet. Y'all think that niggas care about y'all. Like, listen, most of these hood niggas, you're just a cover. They're using your house to push dough.
I'm not gonna lie, I've had some very interesting adventures hanging out with, you know, a hood nigga.
I have to, but no adventures that I don't want. I've had some
interesting adventures. You don't know where the day is going to go. You don't know where he's taking you. And it's crazy because y'all live in the same city, so you just be like, wow, I didn't even know this was here. This is crazy.
It comes to the point where you need to think about who's more important, you or some dick from a dope boy. Like, let's be fucking real. Like, I don't understand. Like, it comes to a point where, like, if you're doing this when you're, like, in high school, okay. But, like, when you get to a point where you're, like, a full fucking fledged adult and you dating niggas on the corner, I really think there's something logically wrong. Like, there's something psychologically wrong with you. Like, when I see, yo, I know girls that are full-blown nurses, got careers, and they literally harboring fucking fugitives in their house.
Please understand, I'm talking about a time and point in my life where I was a teenager. I'm talking about, like, 16. I'm not talking about... 20, I wasn't even legally able to drink. First of all, I wasn't even legally able to get in clubs when I was doing this dumb shit, okay?
Yeah, so shit get real.
I was not a grown woman. I was young. I was young, dumb.
Not young
and stupid, because I didn't know no better. I was young and dumb. When you reach a certain age, you become just stupid. And don't be that.
Don't, because it's embarrassing, and it could really cost you your life. Like, I've seen a lot, and I just be sitting there, like, especially when people don't even be from the life, bro. Like, it's like, you're not from the hood. You don't know what the fuck you're getting yourself into. You think this shit is cute, and then all of a sudden, niggas knocking on your door.
When I was 16, I'm not gonna lie, that was me. That was me. Grew up in the suburbs, lived in a five-bedroom house, three bedrooms. No. Just doing stupid stuff, but I was doing it because I was acting out. Oh. Like, my dad was very, very strict. So I did the complete opposite of what he wanted me to do because I was acting out. I was trying to get his attention. I was trying to get his love. So I would go and do dumb stuff that I knew he didn't want me to do.
Right.
So don't do that. But this is when I was like 16. You got grown women out here doing this type of stuff, and it's just like...
Nah, that's why I don't understand. Like, even with the last drug nigga I dealt with, I didn't even know. Like, that nigga not from the hood. He nowhere near that. Nigga got a full-blown two houses. He going to inherit when his parent died. So I don't understand. I'm like, I don't know why you acting out like that. I even tell... Yo, you know what's funny? When he got caught up and he had me in the car, I said, so you selling drugs? And he had the nerve, the gall, the audacity. No. I said, so why the fuck is this bitch in the backseat talking about something? Oh, take me to 7-Eleven so I can give you the money for the dope, bitch. I'm from the hood, bitch. You better drop me off in the hood, bitch. I know what a drug deal look like. I know what a drug transaction is. Like, niggas be thinking just because I wear heels all the time and I be dressed that I'm from the hood. Like, what is you talking about? Like, so he's like,
my little 16-year-old half itself was just like, oh, this is an adventure. I don't even know what.
Nah, I was livid because that nigga. I was like, I just took myself out of this whole situation of dealing with shitty ass niggas. So you, this is what you're not gonna do. Like, I was so fucking upset. And then I was like, you know what? You doing all of this goofy shit and you don't need to do it. And eventually what's going to happen is you're going to get caught and you're going to fuck your life up. Kid you not, six months later, he got caught. And he fucked his life up. And I was like, that's what happens when you're not from the life and you're trying to be about that life, motherfucker.
That is facts. That is facts. The only reason why I got a pass was because I was tall and I looked older than what I did. Otherwise, that's why, like, a lot of these girls that be going through some of the stuff I was going through, I'm like, I did that at, like, 16. They be like, what? I was a sneaky kid. I got away with a lot just because, first of all, I was a goody two-shoe on the outside. Yeah. So, like, I never questioned this shit. But, like, I was sneaky as hell.
No, that ass. Like, I don't think I was sneaky. I didn't do that much. I could have done more. Knowing how my parents are set up, I'm like, damn, I should have did more. But I didn't feel the need to be honest. Like, I did get to a lot of nonsense, especially with dudes. But it's like, it's come to a point where, like, nah. Like, I was really done with that shit real early. I think by the time I was, like, probably, 18. Like, 16, I was done with it. Like, probably when I was, like, 13, that's when I started liking these little asshole-ass boys. Yeah. And then I started, like, just talking to them, being around the wrong crowd, hanging out with them, holding their weapons. Please don't. Yeah. Holding their weapons. Yeah, being stupid as all hell.
What?
Yeah.
I'm surprised.
I am, too. I used to be real thug life. Like, I used to be very, like, tomboyish. Very, like, I'm not like that no more. Like, I'm very, like, chilled out.
Oh, she said strict parents make sneaky kids. Girl, you ain't lying.
They do.
You're lying, girl. They do. And then it's very dangerous. It's so, like, there were times where I needed to call a parent and didn't because I was somewhere where I wasn't supposed to be.
Right.
But I'm talking about life or death. I'm not talking about, oh, come pick me up, I'm stranded. No, I'm talking about some life or death stuff. And it's like, oh, I can't call mommy and daddy because I'm where I'm not supposed to be.
Nice.
So yeah, I will never be strict to my kids like that. Like I'm gonna have an open door policy where it's like, okay, you get free passes with me.
No, facts. You have to be like that sometimes. Like, it's crazy. Like, I really be thinking back sometimes. Like, I was really out here holding niggas' weapons as if the cops would not stop me and fucking take me in. Like, I live in Jersey where that weapon shit is not tolerated. Like, you will catch a charge off of just having a weapon. Like, I don't know what I was thinking about. Like, but I did used to hold weapons. I've been shot at before. Listen, shit, yeah.
You're way better than me. Ooh.
It wasn't my fault. That's what happens when you hang out with people that you shouldn't be hanging out with. Like, I've been shot at least.
Maybe I wouldn't have been out there as long as I was out there from 16.
No, I stopped. I think 16 was my not
18.
I thought I was 16. I was like, I'm not doing this shit no more because y'all wilding. My last fight was 17, but that bitch deserved it. But I'm retired now. I was like, I'm not doing this. And my parents to this day just found out recently. Because it's funny because like I was so good on the outside, like in school and stuff, that no one knew what I did in the street. And it's like now I tell them, like, oh yeah, I did beat that girl up. They were right. Like, because people would tell them like, oh, we heard this. And I'm like, how could you guys? Now I'm like, oh yeah, I was beating people up. Y'all just didn't know about it. Like, it's true. Like, I used to get into shit all the time. And it's like, now that I think about it, I'm happy I just, yeah. You know what it is? In my hood, they weren't killing bitches. That's what saved me. If they was killing girls where I'm from, I would have definitely been one of the girls dead. Guarantee it.
Look, Nima said, strict parents create great liars. Listen, I was living a double life. Do you hear me? This is why, like, when it comes to influencers portraying themselves to be something that they not. Okay. I refuse to do that shit. I did that shit when I was younger. I'm not doing that shit as a grown fucking adult. So what you see is what you get.
Yeah. Like,
because when you live in a double life, you cannot be yourself. Like you always got to front like you're something that you're not. And so because I was like the goody two shoe, I had to always portray myself to be that. So now it's just like, listen, it's what you see is what you get. And if you don't see it, then that means that's not what you're going to get.
Yeah, I mean, influencers are so good at fucking lying and just pretending. Yeah. And just, I mean, you know what they call it, a persona? A lot of YouTubers do have, like, different personas. Personally, I had to just... I'm as raw as it gets. I don't have different personas. Like, I act like this in church when I used to go. I act like this in front of my parents. I act like this in front of my nigga. He'd be like, I want to date a girl. And I'm like, oh, my bad. Let me turn on the sweet voice. Hi, daddy. Nah. But it slipped out. I'd be like, nigga, the fuck? Like, I'm the same most of the time. Even like, maybe if I come in front of the white man and I want a job, maybe. But even at that, most of the time, my personality is not really changing. Even when I didn't have my locks, I would go into job interviews with my fucking locks and everything. Ain't nobody was about to tell me nothing. If I get the job, fine. If I don't, that's great. Like, I don't need y'all. Like,
be yourself, guys. Like, seriously. Because if you don't, like, you will be suicidal.
Y'all. You will be suicidal.
Depressed. Just be yourself. Like, if you try to be anything that you're not going to be happy. Like, you're not going to be happy. You're going to feel like you have to live a double life. And when I was young, I felt like I had to live a double life. And I said, once I become who I am, like, that's out the window. Like, what you see is what you get.
You're absolutely right. It does come to a point where you do get to that age where you just got to choose. Like, am I going to be me or am I going to just code switch my entire life? And to be someone that I'm not? Like, you all who you are. Like, you are who you are. Like, whether you like it or you don't like it or you love it, it doesn't fucking matter. If people don't like you, they don't like you. But at the end of the day, what matters to you is what matters to you. Like, all these other people don't fucking matter. Like, they really don't. Especially when you don't fucking
You got to get comfortable with the fact that some people just not going to like you. And who cares? Like, as long as you like you, at the end of the day, that's great. And see, my issue was when I was younger, I didn't even like me, because when people didn't like me, I was pretending. I'm like, well, damn, like, you don't like me and I'm pretending?
Yup.
How whack is that? I refuse to do that now. Like, listen, what you see is what you get. And if you don't like what you see, then oh well. Like, I wish you well. Hopefully you got something great going on with yourself, your life. I'm cool with it. If you don't like me, I would rather you not like me for being myself than not like me for being something that I'm not.
Yeah, and that's what it comes down to. People think that that whole be yourself advice is cliche, but it's really true. Because essentially, once you start doing one thing, you're going to start doing other. Once you start conforming your hair, you got to conform your voice. When you conform your voice, you got to conform your personality. You conform your personality, you got to conform everything else. Before you know it, you know who the fuck you are. And then you complaining to everybody else, your discrimination and everything else, which it does exist. I'm not saying it doesn't, because clearly that's what I talk about all the time here. It does exist. But it's coming to a point where it's like, okay, we get mad at them not liking us, but we don't even know who the fuck we are at this point, because we hate them so much that it's like, okay, we get mad because they don't like our afro, they don't like our braids, but what are we stuck doing? Wearing 67-inch Brazilians all the damn time. So when we wear an afro, when we wear our braids, they're like, what the fuck is that? They never seen it before. You know, we get confused that they don't want us to speak in our vernacular, but it's like, they hear us talking like this all the time to the point where it is like, oh my God, what the fuck is you talking about? You know, like...
white boys. Hi, my name's Kiana, and how can I help you today?
Yeah.
I literally talk like that.
Right. You code switch. I feel like code switching is okay, but it comes to a point where if you're doing it to a point where you're hiding your identity and you're hurting, you're hiding your personality, you can't complain when people don't like you, because at that point, they don't know who the fuck you are. Like, they don't, because it's like, okay, one day you coming in talking like this, next day you're coming in talking like this. So it's very confusing, and it's very like... what is going on? Like, Letitia, what happened? Like, they're confused. Sally is like, Letitia, what's happening?
I used to work in corporate, and so you had to come like that. You want to know why? Because they automatically stereotyped you to be
We need to fuck around and have black corporations. We need more people starting black ones.
Exactly.
We need to start, because this is a problem. Like, it's really sad how black people cannot be themselves. And then, like, it creates a disconnect. It really does create a disconnect, because, like, we want to be ourselves, but we can't because we're afraid
of losing our job. Like, I'll never forget when I was working for corporate, and I'll never forget when I sent my first email. They're like, oh my God, you're so professional.
Listen, I'm never going to change myself for a job that wouldn't change for me, period. I'm not going to change for a job that would replace me in 2.5 if I quit. So you either take me out
of the same order. They were so used to, like, wretchedness, I guess. They just couldn't believe that I could use vocabulary words. I'm like, are you freaking kidding me?
Bruh.
You hired me, people. You hired
I've had
me.
I've had it happen all the time. All the time.
I can't stand to work for somebody else. I hate it.
Honestly, I love being a YouTuber, because it's like, ooh, child. I remember last time I've been to a job interview. I've had, like, opportunity interviews with people that be trying to work with me, and I'm like, I don't want to work with you because you stressing me out. I just want to make my life. Like, next time, Skype. Like, Skype, because why am I here? Ooh, child, I've had a couple opportunities where it's like...
I don't want to be under a corporate person. Like, even with the, when it comes to entertainment, when you sign these deals, you're under corporate. There's certain words you can't say. There's certain topics you can't talk about. I don't want to be under those restrictions.
I don't either. That's why most of the time, I've had people, I've had, like, documentaries and just, like, other stuff contact me. And it's like, y'all not about to have me on camera acting like I ain't what I am. Like, that's not.
Black people, like, if you really want true freedom, if you want the freedom that your ancestors never had, start a business. I'm not about to tell you that it's easy, because it's not. But if you really want true freedom, start a business. So then you don't have to report to somebody. Start a business, create some income, and create some passive income. And that's how you're going to reach true freedom. If you have to go and clock in, or if you have to go and water yourself down, whitewash yourself out to be accepted at this particular corporation, you're not really free. Like, that's the reality of the situation. I will never look down on people who work a 9-to-5 job, because I understand why you do what you do.
Yeah.
But make it a goal to start your own business and have some type of personal
something on the side.
Something, because that's going to bring you the freedom that you're really looking for. That's going to bring you the freedom that your ancestors never had. So somehow, some way, create that business.
You're absolutely right. People need to start doing that instead of relying on people. I always tell people, white people ain't your savior. Okay, at the end of the day, I understand y'all need the job, but it's like at the same time, we got to do something. Like, it actually, you know what's funny? Like, since I was a kid, I knew I didn't want to work for people. I remember being like 10, and I told my dad, like, my dad was like, oh, what do you want to do when you grow up? I was like, I'm not working for nobody, so I don't know what it's going to be.
But oh my God, you sound like me.
Yeah, and my dad was like, oh, you have to. I said, no, the fuck I don't. Watch me. Boom.
I was hustling on the playground, okay? I was trying to get me some candy at school. So what I would do is, when I would go to the grocery store with my mom, I'd be like, Mom, give me this magazine. Please, give me this magazine. And it would be like a Jet Black, or it would be some black magazine that would have like the posters in it. It had like little Bow Wow, B2K, Aaliyah in there. So after school, at recess, I would go and sell these posters to people. It'd be like 50 cents, you know? So then I could get me some candy after school, because, right, you know, it would be like 75 cents. Listen, you can make a business anywhere, even though I ended up getting suspended because you can't sell on school
property. Oh, yeah, you can't. Most schools won't let you. It's a liability issue.
I'm selling a poster. But anyway, they called my mom up to the school suspending me for that or whatever. She was like, so this is what you've been doing with those magazines? Okay. I'm like, yeah, but I didn't think it was a big I felt like if I asked you for money for candy after school, you wouldn't give it to me. So if I asked you for a magazine to sell, she's like, I guess.
I mean, that's the thing. You don't even have to have like a business minded mindset to have a business either. Like, you could just sell something. Like, maybe you fucking do hair. Boom, start doing hair on the side. Maybe you are good at artwork. Start doing artwork for people. Honestly, let's not even talk about business. You can just invest in stock. If you invest in stock today, like literally from 10 to 20, 30 years from now, you can be a millionaire. Like, honestly, it's all about just putting your money into something else. If you just want to sit there and rely on white people, okay, corporations, 9 to 5, slaving away, vacations once a year, that's all you want to do and you have nothing, that's going to fuck you up because they can fire you at any time. You're not going to have, that job is not guaranteed. Nothing's guaranteed. Your business isn't guaranteed either, but at least with that business, you would know that you put in the work that you put in or didn't put in. You would know that that's you. But at the end of the day, these people can fire your ass and it's probably not even your fault. Like, it's probably not even your fault. When it comes to your business or anything else, it's one of those things where it's like, you know what you put into it. Like, I know, damn, okay, I didn't do that good on this video. I was lazy. I just threw it out there. That's why I didn't do well. I know specifically, like, all right, I didn't post enough videos this month. That's why my money looked like that. I know you can control that. You genuinely can't control your 9 to 5. At that point, if you walk in and you get fired, it could be hard all you want. And that's a problem. A lot of people complain about shit being hard. Okay, the fuck? It's not meant to be easy.
It was never meant to be easy. And then that's another thing. You don't have to create a freaking business. It can be a hobby, y'all. It don't have to be.
Yeah, it don't have to be no corporation.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it can be something so small, something you enjoy doing. It doesn't have to be something that you hate.
Yeah, you got to just start something. Have something on the side. You know, have your thought money. That's what I call it, thought money. Have your, like, I want a bottle of wine money. Have your something. Because what happens is you're going to end up mad as fuck when you go to work with your new outfit and you got to go return it because now you ain't got a job. You wanted to rely on that job. You thought that they was about to take care of you, and they're not. Like, and that's why I'm like, I don't be watch. Y'all wanted to talk about, oh, it's hard to start a business. That's fine. It's hard to lose your job, too, and not have nothing to fall back on. I ain't gonna say nothing to y'all. Don't be sending me no D-Mafia Speaks emails. Talk about something. Ivana, I just lost my job. Okay. I told y'all to do something, and you ain't doing it, so don't talk to me.
Like, well, listen, keep that corporate job.
Oh yeah, no MLM.
They offer you health insurance, okay?
They do. That's the good part.
That's why I don't knock 9 to 5ers. Like, so yeah, you have health insurance, yeah. 401k plan.
Definitely. Just make sure you got something.
Right. Just make sure you got something outside of that. But make it enjoyable. You don't have to make it like, oh, this is like a second job that I have to go work. But no. Yeah. Listen. You still got health insurance. I cannot stress this enough. Listen, I will never go after a man's money, but his health insurance, oh, I'm sure for sure clocking him on that.
Yeah.
I'm like, you got some health, you got some good health insurance? We can work some out. Listen, we can work some out. But your money, I really don't need your money. Your health insurance, I need that. So I'm trying to see what your health insurance is like. What kind of health insurance you got? Because when it comes to being an entrepreneur, that's something that we don't have. So don't ever feel like you being a 9-to-5 is this bad thing. Like, you have health insurance, pay plan. Like, you have all of these benefits that we as entrepreneurs don't have. I'm saying make something happen on the side. Like, make something shake on the side. Something that you enjoy. But don't ever feel bad for working a 9-to-5 job. Like, these little influencers, listen, they don't have health insurance.
Nigga, they don't have anything. They don't have sense. They don't have a real man or woman in their life. They don't have anything. Trust me, all they have is a follower count that they have not monetized. That's a thing. No,
I'm all about health. So this is like, where your health insurance? Do you have health insurance? Because no one ever talks about this.
Nah,
everybody's like, oh yeah, you should quit your job. You should quit your job. I'm like, okay, let me quit my job. And then I'm like, I don't have no health insurance. Then I'm looking at the marketplace. I'm like,
yo, the marketplace is expensive as shit. I'm like,
you tell me it's $500 a month for health insurance?
Yeah, I'm like, that's a car note.
A premium, a deductible?
I'm like, if I can pay $500 insurance, that means I can afford the Range Rover I want. Like, that's insane. I'm like, maybe I should go get a Range Rover if I can afford it.
Oh my gosh. So all the 9-to-5ers, don't ever feel bad for working a 9-to-5 job. You got health insurance, dental and vision, and a 401k plan, sis.
Right. Or you could just move to Canada where they wait like 6 months for fucking...
The only way you can move... Really-
Let me stop. You know what? Let me shut the fuck up.
But these influencers ain't gonna tell you this because they want to feed you a dream, I guess.
These damn influencers are full of garbage. Like, honestly, I just be... Oh, my God. I be wanting to fucking, like, cut their heads off. Like, influencers be trying to sell you a dream, and a lot of them, like, especially Instagram influencers, a lot of Instagram influencers really don't make any money. Please do not let them fool you.
Twice I was sold a dream. First, when it comes to this health insurance situation, being a self-employed individual. The second one was this high value man bullshit, because I got out here and I'm like, oh yeah, he got money, but he dusty. What do you mean? He has money, but he dusty. He don't got no confidence. If you take his chain away, oh my gosh, like, this is not a man of substance. This is a man that's like a little kid that got mommy issues or abandonment issues. I don't have time for this.
Yo, to be honest, I would hate to get sucked into that, because I see so many girls hypnotized by that whole high quality man being any man and any man that has money, and then they get sucked in, and then, oh God.
It's a scam, you guys. It's a scam, okay? I'm here to tell you that it's a scam, okay? I got played because of it. Like, it's a scam. I fell for that. I'm like, all I have to do is date a man that has money. Okay, cool.
Yeah, money is not comfort. I've learned that. Money is not comfort. I just need a nigga that's not going to cheat on me, and that's not fun. Thank God I'm not in these streets no more. This shit's stressful. Like, I'll be listening to some of my friends like, this is what happened to you, girl.
They played me, y'all. I just, all I can say is focus on a man's character. Character. Back. A man of integrity. Okay? Back. He gonna do right by you when you not looking, and he gonna do right by you even in the midst of his mistakes. That's the best advice that I can give you.
Always.
Like, period. Stop falling into the hype of this high value man. They done ruined it, because high value ain't even high value no more. Anyone can be high value at this point. Just like anybody can go out here and buy Polo. Polo used to be big back in the day. Now it's accessible to just about any and everyone. So
it's just still fucking expensive. I know. That shit's still expensive.
They low key ruined, I'm not gonna lie. They low key ruined Polo. They low key did. They low key. Ain't nobody checking for Polo for real like that.
I just got into it. My boyfriend got me this Polo thing. I was like, yo, this shit cute as fuck. Now I'm being in that store all day.
It was big back in like the early 2000s, but now it's people be on Birkin bags that cost $20,000. So
they need to relax. I would never. Out here taking a loan out for a bag at that point.
Yeah, just focus on integrity, people. Okay. And if someone has integrity, they gonna do right by you, and they have a bigger purpose in life because they understand that. People who have integrity understand that there's more to life than just, I don't know, dumb stuff, materialism and all that other stuff.
Right. Yeah, honestly, child. Like, we gonna see. Like, I really hope that this shit changes. I hope people use more discernment in their decision making, but I highly doubt that's gonna happen. I feel like it's gonna get worse.
Of course.
It's definitely gonna get worse. I mean, we gonna see though. We gonna see. So I think that's it, y'all. I hope you guys enjoyed the live. Make sure you guys go subscribe to our channel. Everything is down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. Actually, the pinned comment not there yet, but it's going to be there eventually when I decide to do my job. But it's definitely in the description box. It's been there for a while. Make sure you guys follow her on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram. And if you care, we're going to be doing my radio show after this on Station Head, which is also down in the description box. So... Okay. We don't know what we talking about because I didn't plan it effectively because I'm a horrible influencer.
No, what is Station Head? Because they reached out to me and I'm like, are you
a fan? It's a radio show app. Like, literally, you do your own radio from your phone. It's lit. Like, you can play music. Subscribers can call in and everything. It's pretty, pretty lit. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, okay. It's pretty lit. So, yeah. Radio is always my thing. So, I jumped at that shit.
Okay, I'm gonna have to tune in to see how it is. Okay. Yeah,
I should be there in about 10 to 15 minutes because I didn't listen. Let's not talk about how I completely didn't do my job. So we're not gonna talk about that. Like, I'm whatever. But this is really great. I'm so happy. You guys need to tune in to the next episode of Civil Discord, which will probably be, if not next week, the week after. Most likely Troyce will be the next person. So make sure you guys stay tuned. Yeah, me and Troyce are gonna be talking about the Black
Community. I feel like Troyce done with Hollywood on us.
Yeah, he wanted to move to LA. I mean, honestly, it was good for him for what he wanted, but I was like, ugh, now I have to visit you in LA. I hate that fucking place, but whatever. Yeah, he living his life these days. So
okay.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Yes, that's life, you know? So I hope you guys enjoyed. See you guys in the next live. Even if it's not a civil Discord, it'll probably be just me. But yeah, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, and I'ma see y'all next time.
Bye, guys.